long, long, boring ride to Gainesville, Florida. I'm heading to the VA hospital to get a MRI of my prostate. There you go. Another day of medical fun. But there will be some fun after this is all over. Mark my words. Made it. I'm in the parking garage at the VA hospital. And of course, Gainesville, Florida, University of Florida Gators. And guess what? You can't see it. But there's one right there with his head sticking up, a little small one right in this pond. Gators, they're everywhere. Alrighty, on to the next destination. Yes, MRIs are brutal. In a tube with all that banging and noises. Oh, while they put headphones on you and I got to listen to smooth jazz. I couldn't hear the smooth jazz, all that banging. Then the guy explained how the entire machine works. But the biggest problem for me was laying in there with my shoulder like this, my arm real tight. I can't sleep on this shoulder. I whacked this thing out one time, 3 o'clock in the morning while loading the boat. I think I dislocated it or something. I cannot sit there with my shoulder like this. Besides the noise and being in that tube, that was the worst part. So now we're actually on to fun. All right. Here we go. Don't have anything like this in Jacksonville. Can you see where we're going yet? Bass Pro Shops. Sportsman's Center. This has supposedly been here for 3 years, and I have been coming to the VA hospital in Gainesville for probably 10 or better. And I didn't even realize they built this. Getting some provisions. You always have to come to the fish tank. There's a big old redfish with a bunch of bass. Here comes a redfish. Two of those are going in the basket. It's funny, I haven't seen any ugly sticks yet. Alrighty, ugly stick row. Not many of them. Well, I saw these Evolution 360 rod holders. I saw these on an aluminum boat in New Zealand. $175 for a rod holder. And it swivels 360 degrees. See? There's the rod. You push a button and your rod swivels. Very nice, but good God, $175 a piece. You don't see these around everywhere. I'm like George Costanza. Gotta check out the restrooms.
That's the most sick. Wow.
Check this out. Gator colors. Orange and blue. Something else, ain't they? Got the old hot foot down there. Wow. Damn, that's a lucky guy. Well, check it out. We've got a red, white, and blue shirt here. A flag shirt. $27. I'm getting it for the 4th of July. I'm getting it. I'm going to be a walking flag. Knives. I don't know if you can see it. See that one right here? $125. That's the kick-ass case. Automatic. Thumb stud. Pocket clip. Of course I like the most expensive one in the case. Of case knives. Well, as it turns out, I'm also a knife snob. Besides a trout snob. I think I just found my cabinet. Yeah, this is more my kind of cabinet right here. Alrighty. Got out of there for $48. I'll show you what I got once I get in the truck. I dropped my GoPro and broke my mount. Look. Show it to you. Look, I broke my little cage mount. I guess I could glue that together or just go on Amazon and get another one for $4.50. It's not a full-blown Bass Pro. It's a Sportsman Center. They didn't have anything stupendous. I need bulk. I was looking to buy bulk. Dulocs, bulk, three ways for making my strong arm rig. But I'll show you what I got. I got an extra, extra large, and it actually fits. I could probably get something just like this on Amazon, but it's made for Chinese people. Got me a flag button-up shirt, and since I'm addicted to these type of lures, I got these giant big shots. They're the same thing as like a gotcha. Of course I'm dropping it all over the place. Same sort of thing as a gotcha plug. I've never seen one before, but instead of metal, they're like solid plastic. Instead of metal, they're solid plastic. And they're easy to change out the hooks with the split rings versus the gotcha plugs. And they're huge. That right there is a Jack Crevalle snack pack. So these are almost 2 ounces, 1 5/16 ounce. So I got four of them because they're cheap. $4.50. So now I got a 2.5 hour ride home.
Wow.
Well, you know what? I've been, I don't know if it's just me or not, but I've been in a lot of stores and restaurants that are very dark inside. You know, when you're looking at detail, like on rods and reels and knives, or the food that you just ordered, or you're trying to read the menu, many times it's very dark. I don't know if it's just me, but I'm in this Bass Pro, and my eyes are hurting from trying to strain to see, because it just seems so dark in there. That's a big complaint I have about a lot of places, trying to save electricity or something. Well, I didn't know if I mentioned it or not. The reason I had to go sit in the tube with all the big banging and clicking and all that, doing an MRI, is they were scanning my lower groinish area because of they got a new technique now that when you do a prostate biopsy, they can hone in. Being normally a prostate biopsy, if you want to know the dirty details, is they go up your butt and then they stab through you 14 times and take 14 samples of tissue to see if it's cancerous. Well, with the MRI, they can go in, spot a bad spot, if there's a bad spot, and then when they do the biopsy, they only hit you once. So the biopsies are terrible also. Not fun. But it's only because of my PSA, is that's how they test for prostate cancer. My PSA is all over the place. It could be a 3, a 4, a 7, a 10, a 9, a 12, a who knows what. And my urologist doesn't know what to do with it. So he said it's time to get checked. So that's the reason why I had to sit in the tube for 40 minutes with all the banging and clanging and my arm hurting like hell. So, there you go. A lot of men die from prostate cancer because they never get it checked. Well, I have a history of it because my dad had prostate cancer. I'm on the every six month alert system with my urologist through the VA. So there you go. So thanks for tagging along. And the Bass Pro Shops, not that great. Not much different than Academy or anything really. It was just it's not a huge experience like the one down in South Florida, that's for sure. You see this? This is the reason I don't travel. This is the reason I go nowhere. Because guess what? There's an accident. And there's three lanes of I-10 completely clogged up. Yeah, that's the reason why I don't go anywhere. I love the smell of diesel in the afternoon. Did you know that?
I'm home. How do I look? I look exactly like a 4th of July tablecloth. Yeah, I don't get along well without the patriotic. There you go. Oh, one more thing.
All right, I showed you my nickel bolstered G10. S30V Buck 110. Now, we're gonna
solve a little issue and to make this one-handed opening, I've got a little thumb stud kit. Not sure if everybody knows about these. I am going to install it right now. All right, so basically you want it, when you go to open, you can grab that thumb stud and bam. So it looks to me, got a groove built in the bottom, and over here's a set screw. It's just that simple. This is like a little $6 item. So if I put it right there, let's see, and you tighten it up just like that. I'm going to have to get another one of these because I got another buck 110 exactly like this coming. All right, so I put the texture side over here. Let's see. Okay, let's try it again. I'm wondering if it should be back a little bit. Like right there. Let's just try it. Oh, no. That's a little high. So, gotta get it right. So you're nice and comfy. Got yourself a comfy thumb stud. I'm gonna bring it back towards the bolster just a hair more. What did I just say? This ain't rocket science, folks. It's just little tiny pieces and parts here. All right, let's try it. It does put a little divot in the blade, so it looks like. I guess that's okay. Yeah, there you go. All right, so that's the end of the day. I appreciate you stopping by. God, I'm telling you how sweet this is. Silver nickel bolsters, G10, textured just really, really nice. S30VN or S30V classic buck blade. I'm not a fan of the super fan of the clip point, but I like it because it's all buck. I have to say, this is probably, and you know me with Mr. Cold Steels, but this is probably the one of the nicest knives I've ever had. And you know, I got a bunch. Black Talon. Plain Edge Tiger Claw. Spare Serrated Tiger Claw. Another Spare Tiger Claw. And the Tiger Claw that I carry every day. And one of my other super favorites, because this is an Orlwalk original. This right here is so tough. The Essie Avispa. So there's just a little bit. And then of course, you know, I've got a whole bunch of these Cold Steel Super Edges. It's a little micro knife that can do a whole lot. But when it comes to big knives, I've got a few of these, and I have to say, this buck mixed with one of these, this is a safety item / self-defense, and this is one fine just plain bladed knife. See how they sort of kind of go together with that G10. All right, enough rambling. I'll see you on the next one.